Hi, my name is Sean Lewis. Thank you for tuning in today. I'm 29 years old. I'm from Tulsa, Oklahoma. I believe I have a message to inspire and encourage everybody from all walks of life. And I believe God is calling me to carry this message around the world. For I believe that no matter who you are, no matter whether it's a physical challenge or some other kind of challenge, emotionally, spiritually, whatever it is, I believe that we all have a purpose, we all have a dream, we all have a destiny given to us by God. I have cerebral palsy, but I do not let my cerebral palsy define who I am, what I'm about, or whether or not I can accomplish my goals or dreams or not. And I can assure you that whatever challenges you might be facing, you can beat them. You can defeat them. You have two choices in life: to rise up and beat and defeat your challenges, or let your challenges define who you are and what you're going to be for the rest of your life. No, you may not know where you want to be. No, you may not be where you want to be. For some of you, you might not know where that is. But I assure you, no matter what your challenge in life is, you're not an accident. God has a purpose, a plan, a destiny for each one of you. And what my goal is by making these tapes is to inspire you, to encourage you, and to help you reach your goals and reach your destiny and point you to a personal relationship with my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Because you see, the Bible says, what does it profit a man to gain the whole world but lose his soul? I can give you all the motivation, all the strategies, and all the stuff you need to help you reach your goals. But if you don't have the foundation, and if you don't know the person who created the world, who created the planets, and who created you before the foundation of the world, you're gonna lose your soul. But thank God that God gave us a way out through His Son, Jesus Christ. For the Bible says in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, whoever believeth within Him shall not perish but have everlasting life. See, you and I have a problem. We were born into sin. There's nothing we can do about it. But by God's grace, and by His mercy, we have an advocate, which is another word for lawyer, in heaven, in the form of Jesus. And He died, and He paid the price for years of my sins, so we can spend eternity with Jesus. And, you know, God wants you to succeed even more than you want to succeed. But you know what? I encourage you to get to know God. Check out Romans 10:9-10. And find a good Bible that you can understand. Go to a good Bible-based church. I am a Christian. All my beliefs and my principles are shaped and guided by my walk as a Christian. But I believe anybody can be inspired and motivated by my stories, by my motivation and principles. I tailor my presentations to where I'm at. I work in community organizations, schools, businesses. I've worked with sports teams. I can do graduations. I'll go anywhere that needs a speaker. If you'd like more information, how to book me, I'll explain how to do that at the end of this YouTube update. But today, I want to talk to you about a line I heard in a movie which I happen to love, and God inspired me to build a tape around it. It's from the movie We Bought a Zoo. And the line is, all you need is 20 seconds of insane courage for something amazing to happen, you know? And we all have stories we tell ourselves, the reason why we can't do something, the reason why this won't work, the reason why this won't work. And we all have, and whatever you believe about yourself will come to pass, because however you believe, that will come to pass. Because as a man or woman thinks, so are they. If you think you won't achieve anything, then you won't even try. But if you take the limiter off your life, just like they put a limiter on a go-kart to keep it from going very fast, if you'll take, a lot of us put a limiter on our life, and we put a ceiling. But if you'll take the limiter off your life, you can achieve your goals and dreams. It's all up to you. But you can't let the fear stop you. You know, I have cerebral palsy, but I don't let my challenge or my disability stop me or define me from who I want to be. I've been to college. I graduated in May of 2007. With a degree in human services and applied sciences. And now I use that combined with the knowledge that God has given me, with the knowledge that I learned in school and other sources God's allowed me to find. I use it, all the resources I have to inspire you and encourage you, but I can't read. I can't write with the exception of my name. I did all my tests orally. I memorized all my book reports orally. And everything I do, I have to memorize or do it extemporaneously, which means off the top of my head. But you know what? I graduated college with a 3.9 GPA, and you know, besides being a motivational speaker, I'm working on building my own business, because not only does God want you to be God wants you to be successful in every area of life, spiritually, physically, financially. And if you're not whole in all those areas, you're an incomplete person, and God wants you well. And it says in the Bible, in Deuteronomy 8:18, you can check it out for yourself, God will give you power and ability to get wealth. The Bible also says we're blessed to be a blessing. The Bible also says the love of money is the root of all evil. Money is meant to be a tool, a resource for you to help yourself and help your family. It's never meant to take the voice of God. But God doesn't care if you're a billionaire or a millionaire. As long as that money doesn't take the place of your relationship with Him. Because after all, whatever talents, skills, and abilities God has given you come to you by God. Whether you acknowledge them or not, we can't even take a breath without our lungs and the body God has created for us. So everything we have comes from God. And you know, I want to talk to you today about bringing through fear. All it takes is 20 seconds of insane courage to make something happen, to make that phone call, to close that business deal, to ask that girl on a date, to get that girl's phone number, to make a decision to start a business. But in anything in life, you must have a plan and a strategy on how to get there. A lot of people go through life just hoping for miracles and hoping and throwing stuff against the ceiling to see what happens. No, no, no. You gotta have a detailed plan, a detailed strategy on how to get there. You gotta have a GPS, so to speak, for your life, for your life. And you must constantly renew your mind, reprogram your mind, because your mind is the greatest computer in the world. But you gotta reprogram it to think differently, because everybody has the same 24 hours in a day, but not everybody thinks like everybody else. You gotta think outside the box. You gotta be willing to be unsatisfied with the status quo and go after everything God has for you. And the first way you can do that is to give your life over to Him. Find out what He has for you, and then go in the Word and find out what His promises are for you, and begin to study those out and apply those, and listen to books, listen to any kind of books, but especially like motivational books. Even I, as a motivational speaker, even I love to listen to all kinds of stuff. I read fiction and nonfiction alike. Here's some of my favorite nonfictional people that I like to listen to. Tony Robbins is a good one for me. John C. Maxwell. Zig Ziglar. And there's a good book by Dale Carnegie called How to Win Friends and Influence People. And, you know, God gave you incredible gifts, but you must develop them. Michael Jordan didn't become a great basketball player just by osmosis. No, ma'am. No, sir. What did he do? He developed them. He constantly was in the gym working on his shot. And, you know, you must be willing to sacrifice stuff for what you truly want, even if it's just for a period of time. Now, you may not be able to check out the movies every time you want to go or go to a concert. But if you put in the time and the work and the strategies to get where you want to get, you'll get there. You'll be able to inspire and encourage people with your gifts. Because, see, we all got to work together. We all have a purpose. We all have a dream. We all have a destiny. And without you doing what you're supposed to do, it's incomplete. Because, see, we're all like a big puzzle, you understand? And we all fit together. Without one, if you don't have every piece of the puzzle, how many of you know that that puzzle is not going to go together and look right, no matter how much you want it? But I encourage you, find out what you want to do today and go out and do it. People ask me all the time, how do I find out what I'm gifted at? I say, it's simple. Whatever you like doing, whether it's music, whether it's online, or whatever it is, start with what you would do every day for free, and that's a good indication of what you're supposed to be doing. What would you do every day in your life for free if you didn't get paid for it? whatever that is, that's a good indication of starting to find out what you're passionate about. Don't follow money. Follow your passion, and the money will come, because you need money to live in the world. We all know the more you have, the easier things is. And God wants you to have money, but money is not happiness. That's why you see some successful people that they're not happy. They want to commit suicide. They want to kill themselves. You know, there's people that have money that they're sick. Their family's all busted up. They fight all the time. They're a mean, angry person. You know what? God wants you to have wholeness and peace in every area. God wants you to have wealth and riches in every area that adds no sorrow to your life, that adds complete and total joy to your life. I want to be able to take care of my family, to take care of, people I know that need help, to provide for my mom and take care of my mom. My mom's been a great mom to me. My mom has been my biggest supporter. I wouldn't be the man I am today without God and my mom's support. So thanks, Mom, for everything you do. My mom is one of my biggest role models, because she goes through and does what she needs to do and doesn't complain about it. But she has fibromyalgia, which is a muscle disorder, which is caused by overactive nerves that makes you feel like you have the flu all the time. But does my mom ever complain about it? No, sir, no, ma'am. She just keeps plugging along and goes and does what she needs to do. One of my favorite authors, John C. Maxwell, says, life is 10% what happens to you, 90% how you react to it. So you can turn your life around. Attitude determines altitude. If you have a bad attitude, nothing's gonna go right in your life. And if you go around saying, nothing ever good happened to me, guess what? That's exactly what you'll get. And I just wanna encourage you to write me back and let me know what you think of this video. Repost it, retweet it, and don't forget to hit subscribe. Also, I have another channel, Great Expectations 82, where I review books, movies, music, entertainment, fun things I think people should do, check out and see, as well as videos of me under just the my life, so check that out. And you can find me at Sean, SeanGodsMan 26 at gmail.com. I'm on Twitter under the same name, Sean Godsman 26. And just email me or call me or whatever. And if you want me to come speak, feel free to contact me. I'll send you the necessary information. Thanks for listening, and God bless. Have a wonderful day and have a great week. All right. And remember, if you don't go, you'll never know. All right. So live your dreams and believe you can do it, and you can achieve whatever you can dream. The Bible says in Psalm 37:4, delight yourself in the Lord and he'll give you the desire of your heart. So God bless. You can do it. Whatever is within God's plan for you, he will make sure you achieve it if you will be faithful to put in the work. God will put his super on your natural, and the two of you will get it done together, all right? God bless. All right, bye-bye.